Welcome to this How to ctrlX automation video from Bosch Rexroth. This video shows the programming of S20-KNX module within the works. We start our project with XM2 controller. Go to the S20 I/O node and open with the right mouse button the list of available S20 modules. Select the S20-KNX module. Now we need two libraries for the KNX communication. Go to the Library Manager at Library. Search for S20-XM. And the second one we searched for KNX. Inside of the KNX library, you find a folder with code examples. Here are examples for the KNX client and all data points available. These examples are text files, and the examples are programmed in structure text. I have prepared the example for the data point 1 in the function block diagram language. It is the same as in the library. I imported the example to our project. In our example is important EN bus type. And the slot number for the KNX module. In our example, it is 1. The two function blocks are for the KNX communication. Here is the call of the two function blocks for the data point communication. One is an example for reading and one for writing. The enabled signal only makes sense if the client device reports that it is in operation. Here is the data point type ID. In our example, here it is 1. The timeout monitoring of the function block. The KNX handle from the KNX client function block. The valid flag. Status for the selected data point ID. And the actual value which is read from the data point ID. Behind this example for reading. Here is the example for writing. Here is important the set value. It is the value to write in the selected date of point ID. All the other parameters are nearly the same. Now we need the I/O configuration for the KNX module. We open the KNX module and start the mapping. At first we need to control word. Now the array of the complex protocol. The outputs. Now the status word. And at the end the complex protocol array for the inputs. Now we must call the program inside of the PLC program. Now we can download our program. And we see our program is running. And the KNX communication is running because we got the inoperation flag. The only thing which is important that you need. ETS program inside of your KNX module. That's what I wanted to show you. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful for you. If you have any comments or suggestions, please comment them below. Enjoy ctrlX automation and be 2 steps ahead.